Welcome to Top Crew Aviation. This is Captain P.K. Yadav. Today we are going to study about ATS. Full form of ATS is Air Traffic Service. Now, what is Air Traffic Service? Air Traffic Service is a service which regulates and assists aircraft in real time to ensure their safe operations, guys. As we all know about responsibilities of traffic police in our local area, now there must be a management who is managing all type of activities related to traffic in all cities, right? So would come under traffic services, guys. In a similar fashion, services related to air traffic is known as air traffic service. All right, guys, I hope you have understood it. So now, in particular, ATS is to, number one, prevent collisions between aircraft, provide advice of the safe and efficient conduct of flights, conduct and maintain an orderly flow of air traffic, guys. This is the, I would say, major work of ATS. Notify concerned organizations of and assist in search and rescue operations, guys. So these are the basic things which are the responsibilities of ATS services. I'm sure you must have understood about basic idea. What is ATS? What are the responsibilities of ATS? And what is the major role of ATS in aviation? Now, let's move further. ATS has divided into four types of services in India. Number one is alerting service. Number two is FIS, known as Flight Information Service. Number three is advisory service. Number four is ATC. So let's start with alerting services, guys. A service provided to notify appropriate organizations regarding aircraft in need of search and rescue, aid and assist such organizations as required, guys. So the main task of this alerting service is to notify the appropriate organizations which are locally available, those who can help in search and rescue, guys. All right. So to whom we provide alerting services? All aircraft provided with air traffic control service, all other aircraft having filed a flight plan or otherwise known to the air traffic services as far as applicable or practicable. Any aircraft known or believed to be in the subject of unlawful interference, guys. So what we can say, as name suggests, what is alerting service, guys? Alerting service are the service, you know, which provides notification to the concerned authority when related to the search and rescue. Okay, so whenever any aircraft is in distress, alerting service will send the notification to the concerned authority. They just provide the notification. They do not do any kind of service. They just provide the notification. Now, let's talk about flight information service. So, flight information service is a service provided for the purpose of giving advice and information useful for the safe and efficient conduct of flights, guys. So very simple, flight information service. So where do we provide? We provide flight information service in uncontrolled area, guys. All right. Now note, guys, SAR means search and rescue, which comes under alerting service, and FIS, flight information services, are provided to all identified aircraft either has filed flight plan or in touch with ATC, guys. That is it about FIS services and alerting services. Now we will discuss about advisory services. So guys, air traffic advisory service is a service provided within advisory airspace to ensure separation in so far as practical between aircraft which are operating on IFR flight plan. So overall, guys, in this service, ATC will use advice. Let's say, for an example, Victor Tango Alpha Bravo Charlie advised to descend flight level 60. Note, guys, PANS ATM, like, comes under ICAO DOC 4444. So do remember this line, PANS ATM comes under ICAO DOC 4444. Very important question for your Viva guys. You have to remember the full form of PANS ATM. PANS ATM stands for like procedures for air navigation services, and ATM is air traffic management. Guys, this is easy, but it is very important. They check your basics by asking common full form, because in day-to-day life we use ATM. In case if you are not aware about PANS ATM, you are going to tell them about master and visa and you are gone. So don't make this kind of silly mistakes. Any full form which is related to day-to-day life, make sure that you know the full form and you do not give the basic answer related to day-to-day life. They just check your basics, guys. Okay, so the last one is ATC. Okay, air traffic control is a service provided by air traffic controllers. Okay, there are 3 to 4 types of air traffic controller, and we will cover them. Number one, SMC, surface movement control. Number two is aerodrome controller. Number three is approach controller. Number four is area control. So these are 4 ATC guys we would discuss in our upcoming video. But over here, what we have to understand, something like if ATC is providing any instructions, let's say Victor Tango Alpha Bravo Charlie, descend flight level 60. Over here, PIC is bounded to comply with. All right, guys, you have to descend. So if we talk about exam, you have to follow ATC, but whenever we do practical flying, guys, do remember PIC is the whole soul. If you do not think, you have to follow ATC instructions, you can do something better. Do that, guys, because you are the only one. You know the real situation. PIC knows better than ATC in terms of emergencies or in terms of safety or in terms of, I would say, weather, guys. So in practical flying, your decision would be the final decision. But if we talk about RT exam, follow ATC instructions blindly, guys. I hope everything is clear. In case if you have any doubt, guys, do let me know. I'm here to help you. So that's it for today. Bye for now, guys. Take care. Here you go, your checklist. Like, subscribe, and share.
Thank you for watching.